The conventional wisdom these days is that autocracy is ascendant, democracy on the decline. But the reality is more complex. In Myanmar, Sudan, Russia, Belarus, Nicaragua, Poland, and Uganda, people have recently taken to the streets to demand democracy, even at the risk of being arrested or shot. There are few rallies for autocratic rule. In some countries ruled by autocrats that retain at least a semblance of democratic elections, opposition political parties have begun to paper over their policy differences to build broad alliances in pursuit of their common interest in ousting the autocrat. Such coalitions succeeded in removing Czech Prime Minister Babic and Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu. They are challenging Hungarian Prime Minister Orban and Turkish President Erdogan.
I, Joseph Robinette Biden Jr., do solemnly swear.
A similar coalition in the United States chose Joe Biden to run against Donald Trump. As autocrats can no longer rely on subtly manipulated elections to preserve power, a growing number are resorting to electoral charades that guarantee their victory but confer none of the legitimacy of an election. We have seen these desperate zombie elections in Hong Kong, Nicaragua, Belarus, Russia, Uganda, and Iran. All of these developments spell trouble for the autocrats. Yet we must recognize that autocrats are enjoying their moment in the sun in part because of the failings of democratic leaders. Today's challenges are big. The climate crisis, the COVID-19 pandemic, poverty and inequality, racial injustice, the threats from modern technology. But today's democratic leaders are often too mired in short-term partisan battles to address these problems effectively. If democracies are to prevail, their leaders must do more than spotlight the autocrats' shortcomings. They must ensure that democracy delivers on its promised dividends. Otherwise, they risk fueling the frustration and despair that are fertile grounds for the autocrats.